I'm grateful to the organizers for giving me an opportunity to represent my work. It was done in collaboration with this Alexei from Maximilian Ludwig University in Munich. And the message of this talk is that if we include conduction electrons alongside with the spins in our teaching, greatly enhances opportunities for exotic physics. And in this particular talk, I will discuss the model realization of chiral spin liquid. And what is the problem? So usually interactions between magnetic moments lead to some kind of magnetic order where the order parameter is linear, well, antiferromagnetism, ferromagnetism, etc. Or quadratic in helical magnets and pneumatics in valence bond solids. But there is another possibility of so-called chiral spin order, which includes order parameter made of three spins. And the seminal example of such kind of spin order was suggested by Kalmayer and Larkin in the 80s. This order parameter breaks parity and time reversal. But I think that we still lack a realistic microscopic model for construction order or models we include finely tuned interactions of many sides. So again, let me explain better what kind of liquid is. Well, the order parameter would be a mixed product of three neighboring spins in the order I consider. There will be short distant spin order, which is destroyed by fluctuations at long distances. So at long distances, only chiral spin order will survive. But in order to have a good idea why this order parameter is not zero, you can look at this a picture, and some spin components alternate antiferromagnetically between sides, and other spin components are rotated in a set pile. And they do it in such a way that the mixed product remains constant, but the individual spin projections will experience long range order. So the model is actually a Kondo lattice with an additional short range Heisenberg exchange. And the asymptotic situation when the spins are on square air lattice. Yes, the model is two-dimensional, and this is important. This is important because in the dimensions you can break as you do significantly at finite temperatures, and therefore any conventional spin order is not possible. Now, we are asking very little from the conduction electrons. So what we are asking is that the electron system has a strong response on some incommensurate wave factor Q. So ideally, this would happen if the Fermi surface has a nest, but not necessarily. Strong maximum of the magnetic susceptibility, it can be realized in many ways. Basically, what we do after that, we integrate out conduction electrons and get RTT-Y interaction, which has a momentum space, it has a maximum of this wave vector Q. So, and we assume and we prove that the spins can be decomposed in slow and fast components in this way. So this trigonometric functions are fast variables and orthogonal vectors 1, 2, 3, and this end of alpha are slow variables. This decomposition respects the fact that S squared is possible. And after that, we use bus integral for modulation for the spins and integrate out electrons in the presence of this spin background. This sine alpha is actually the order parameter of this chiral speed indicator. Integrating out the electrons, we get this ground state energy, which is a function of alpha. And once it has a minimum at non-zero alpha, we get our speed in limit. So how does it look like? First of all, there is an antiferromagnetic alternation of one component of the spin, and then spiral of the transverse component. But as I said, since we are into the dimensions, this slow variables E1, E2, E3 cannot order. They remain disordered. So that's several formulae for the ground state energy, and you see that there is a non-trivial minimum for alpha naught equal to zero, as soon as the Heisenberg exchange becomes of the order of the archetypal intervention. So as soon as the Heisenberg exchange becomes larger than the archetypal intervention, we get this chiral speed in it. And this is the order of parameters of the chiral spin liquid. The mixed product of three neighboring spins, you see it is proportional to the average of this sine alpha, and it oscillates. Oscillates with vector Q, and it oscillates with the wave vector of the length. The phase transition is of the Eisen in the Eisen universality class. Because the sine alpha just can be of plus one minus sine. So that's Heisenberg along this lines the value of the opposite Heisenberg interaction, and this is the critical point, as I said, is of the order of the archetypal. So now, what happens with the spins? We derived the effective Ginzburg-Landau reaction. So I remind you that we are at finite averages. So we are actually interested in classical thermal fluctuations of the spins. And then this Ginzburg-Landau energy, which describes fluctuations of this of the linear of unit vectors P1, P2, P3. It has a rather ugly and complicated form, but this is essentially a non-linear signal model due to the fact that we are on a lattice with archetypal interaction. There is no Lorentz invariance here, which makes analytical calculations rather difficult. But nevertheless, we can be confident that it does not order, because there is still a continuum SU2 symmetry here, and this SU2 symmetry can be spontaneously broken into dimensions. So, the simple models of that sort were studied earlier in the context of non-linear magnetism a long time ago. And the conclusion is always that the correlation length is exponential. Sorry, not minus, but plus. Is exponential large in average. Correlation length is exponential. So now, there are possible candidates for this kind of behavior. We found, at the moment, we found one which combines two dimensional electrons and speed. So this is it is a combination of this metal and sandwiched between what insulating vanadium oxide. So spins with the Heisenberg interactions are here, and the electrons are here. So this advantage in this case that unfortunately there is spin susceptibility has a maximum at a conventional criteria, which will change the physics. But hopefully somebody will be inspired by this and find a better realization. So, and I finish with the message that inclusion of reduction electrons in the picture which generate RTK-like interactions greatly increases possibilities for this process.
Magnetic transition
somewhere. polarity. But in principle, in two plus, in quasi-two-dimensional system, you may have a situation where there will be Ising phase transition first and magnetic phase transition after. So you may have at intermediate temperatures, you may have a phase disguised in other world.
Also, I have another question. I don't understand why the Chiral's other parameter oscillates. Because the classical spiral, it looks to me it's just a constant. The triples
product. Well,
is there any physical reason?
Just take this, what multiplied the nearest neighbor, it oscillates. Because this kind of order is made from this spiral. That's why they only don't. Sorry. Yes, sir. These guys are actually. These guys actually constants. Who put oscillates antiferromagnetically? There is antiferromagnetic oscillation because the Heisenberg exchange is antiferromagnetic. But actually, you could choose ferromagnetic exchange, but you just thought that antiferromagnetic is more correct and easy. And then it will be more.
So once you develop Chiral orders, so is it possible that the nesting condition becomes broken?
Once you have this, the electron spectrum will acquire a gap.
Yes.
This is nesting. Which is the reason? Which is the reason why this law is not seen?
Okay.
This is the spectrum gap. Is the nesting.
So how important is the nesting here? So it's not necessary.
Sorry.
So I was asking. So how important is the nesting condition here? So it's not really a necessary condition, right?
I think it's enough to have a maximum that a sufficiently strong maximum at this way.
Thank you. Any other questions? Okay, can we thank Alexei and all the speakers?